The 2022 Prescient Freedom Pedal is proudly brought to you by Prescient. Cape Town, South Africa's crown jewel and the most European city on the continent. Founded by the Dutch East India Company in 1652, it was South Africa's first attempt at a modern metropolis, earning its nickname the Mother City. Regularly voted one of the most beautiful cities in the world, Cape Town is the second largest city in South Africa and one of the most popular destinations for tourists due to its amazing quality of life and its breathtaking natural beauty. Cape Town is home to 3.5 million people and one of the most visually spectacular and culturally unique cities on the planet, harboring a dramatic coastline in the shadow of the Table Mountain National Park, and it is as picturesque as its history is long. This Freedom Day, the 27th of April, once again saw the cream of South Africa's ocean paddlers converge on Cape Town for the 2022 edition of the annual Prescient Freedom Paddle, a 27-kilometre race around the iconic Robben Island. This is a special day for many people in this country, with the Prescient Freedom Paddle playing homage to the legacy of heroes who made it possible for South Africa to have this democracy. Since its inception in 2018, the circumnavigation of the island that housed former President Nelson Mandela and many other political prisoners has become an event to celebrate our nation's freedom. The organizers have moved boldly to make the event accessible to a wide variety of ocean paddle craft while promoting shorter alternatives for the less skilled and fit paddlers. With over 370 paddlers, from first-timers to juniors to national champions, this iconic event provides a platform for people from all walks of life to engage with Nelson Mandela's legacy, all backed by the race's loyal supporters.
Well, on Freedom Day, we celebrate our journey to democracy and freedom. And in the context of the world today, freedom has in many ways been tested and pushed through the pandemic and through the war more recently. At Prescient, we value individual freedoms and we recognize the benefit of diversity and working together as a team. And we can think of no better way than to celebrate our freedom by taking a paddle around the ultimate symbol of freedom, being Robben Island.
Can we get out there and be the vibe out there? So the guys better watch out. If you want some tunes out there, just join the slip.
Always ready.
The event is pretty unique in the paddling world, where we don't focus purely on the top of the field, the elite races. We have got probably 10 world champions that take part in this event, but we also cater for everyone, down to the juniors, the under 12s. We just want to do a short, but be part of the excitement that we have here.
Today is Freedom Day, so take a moment when you're going on Robben Island.
Freedom Day!
The build-up for this race starts months in advance. The amount of behind-the-scenes IT computer work that builds in. And then on the day before, I think we're here at 5 o'clock in the morning, we start building and we build racks, we build everything. We've just got to get everything organized because we've got registration in the afternoon. We have 380 paddlers coming down. They're expecting, we've set a bar, they're expecting a good experience. We want to give them a good experience. And then on race day, we're back here. I think we were here at 5:30 a.m.
Yep,
this morning.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I think that's what makes us so unique. It's all about the paddlers. We are here for your needs, and we put your needs first.
To make the event as inclusive and accessible as possible, the organizers have two shorter course distances and open the event to a wide variety of different ocean paddle-powered craft for the 2022 edition. The traditional surf skis will be joined by stand-up paddleboarders, prone paddlers, ocean sculls, and ocean kayaks.
Freedom Paddle is—it's an amazing vibe at the start. You know, you've got this very contained area where a lot of people are getting on the water together, and you can really feel a lot of excitement getting onto the water. And I think that's one of the things that really makes the event quite nice. And especially that they've got all the different courses now running as well—the short courses, medium courses—they've got a lot of different crafts. So a lot of excitement on the water, and seeing all those boats lined up to head out to Robben Island is quite a sight. So when you see the start, it's quite something to behold.
At the start of the 2022 Freedom Paddle, the Prescient Freedom Paddle on Freedom Day. You can see behind me one of the best fields lined up. We're going for a really, really exciting race. You can look and see the guys are heading out to their 27k trip to Robben Island, and the conditions are perfect. We're going to have a little bit of a south swell running, which will pick up the guys on their way to the island. It's going to help them get there a little bit quicker, the first 8k's to the island. It's not going to be easy coming back. The wind is going to pick up slightly, but it really is good condition. So our top crews we're looking at, we've got Josh Finn and Hank McGregor, double defending champion. Remember, this is the South African Championships, the S2 Championships. We've got Andy Burkett and Nick Notton. We've got Kenny Rice and Uli Hart. So we're really in for an awesome, awesome race. Watch very closely Bridget Hartley and Pippa McGregor. The McGregor's looking to do a double in the men's and women's race. That could be quite special. It's a record field, 370 people. Such a good turnout on such a good day. It's in the middle of the week. People have come from around the country, from Gauteng, from KZN. Even with their problems, they've still come down, and it's really a great field. The vibe has been fantastic. The field's on the water. We've got rowing boats. We've got the coastal rowers. We've got sub guys out there. We've got prone guys. An awesome, awesome, awesome day. Baby, wait, I know that you're afraid, but it'll be okay if you just stay with me.
So the start of this race is always very, very fast, and so basically it's like a 2 kilometer flat out sprint. The bunch kind of figures itself out, and there's a lot of intervals going, and after you've gone hard for 2Ks, then you go a little bit harder for the next 8.
They lined us up a little differently this year, so the girls were all together, which is actually kind of nice, and then the top men and then the rest of the people, so the start had to be quite good.
main event has been dominated by Hank McGregor, the 11 times world marathon champion, who has won this title 3 times in succession, and always against a field loaded with some of the world's best exponents of surf ski racing. This will also decide the national S2 championship titles for 2022. An interesting aspect to the race is that entrants are not obliged to reveal who their partners in the doubles race are when entering, and hence the racing combinations are not known until much closer to race day.
You know, it comes down to the conditions. You know, obviously today was an out and out flat race, and we could have paddled canoes and made it around the island safely. That did put a spanner in the works because, you know, there was bunch riding intervals and stuff like that, whereas, you know, there was very little assistance from the ocean.
When you get to close to Robben Island, the swell tends to wrap around and get to that end of the island. So that's one time, especially in a double ski with them, that if you can hook onto one of the swells, you can really put a bit of a gap and like really burn. And especially if someone else is out of position, you're like, if you get that little boost, you know, next thing it turns into 2 boat lengths. So it's a very crucial part of the race. So either you can do damage or you can try and do some damage prevention.
With this race, there are no free kilometers in this event. It's a hard paddle from start to finish.
Yeah, we got to the 5K mark, funny enough, and the bumps arrived. And yeah, we started pushing the pace. Power came from behind.
That's a very, very tense time in the race. So we caught a little bit off guard, but we did manage to sort of close that gap. Hank obviously a lot of experience, but he knows exactly when he's gonna go, and you can see every now and then he has a cheeky look, and he knows when it's gonna be worse for you.
You are working the ocean for anything that's out there. Whether if there's a little bump, you're trying to go for it. And especially going to the island, that burns a lot of energy, a lot of matches.
We sort of split the bunch. Everyone sort of came off. The closest boat to us was Nicky and Andy.
Hank put in a massive surge, got away. Andy and Nick then went to try and catch up to them. You know, we were sort of in a bit of no man's land.
You just got to find a rhythm. It's 27, 28 kilometers. I decided then you just got to focus on yourself. And if you're feeling good, you just keep it up.
We found an amazing rhythm going into the island. And as soon as Nick and Andy caught up to Hank and Josh, I think maybe they kind of slowed down a little bit, just consolidated. And that just gave us a little bit of basically 5 minutes where we had a great rhythm and we could catch up to them again.
So fortunately, we were able to come back. And by the time we got to the island, then we were together, and I think both, it was sort of a bit of a mutual understanding, I think, when we both got together, that like, no one's gonna break away right now.
And then it was a 3-horse race around the island.
You see, you certainly don't want to get too close to that kelp. You don't want to get stuck any kelp in your understern rudder. So those kelp beds are just on the other side of them. You're going to have to squeeze through the S1s and the kelp forest there. So that'll be interesting to see if Hank puts anybody into the kelp, although he's on the inside line. So
there you got Hank and the guys, the top 3 guys going past the S3, one cross. Just enjoying this day, they get to see it for a short while there.
While the front of the race was next level, most paddlers at the Prescient Freedom Paddle were there just to make it around the island and enjoy a spectacular day out on the water in Table Bay.
Beautiful!
Berg over there, over the top of the island, there's a shipwreck. There's B-Rack.
Woo!
Hey. And not too many sizable waves out the back.
Today?
So coming around the island, now there's four of us coming around the island, and there are about three or four reefs at the back there that you need to keep an eye on, and especially when there's a decent sized swell like there was today. You don't want to be too deep because you're going to be paddling further, you know, 300 or 400 meters behind the back line or right on the back line. It's kind of the same. I think just behind the waves, you can get a bit of an advantage there. So we took up a pool just near the end, and I wanted to come as close to the waves as possible to try and get as much advantage there. It's at this point where I started fatiguing a bit, and then I just had the powerhouse behind me just basically pushing right to the end.
As you come around the island and you start to see sort of your final line, getting your course right, because at that point you can screw up if you go even a few degrees off. You kind of start counting down the kilometers now. You're like, you know, you have less to go than you've done. So I was feeling a little bit sensitive. I felt every time I put in power, then Andy was putting in power behind me. So I was pretty confident that Andy was feeling good.
We had had a chat before the race, a very loose game plan, which revolved around hopefully having some energy coming back from the island, which I think everyone tries to hope for. And I think from the back, I was always trying to sort of gauge how hard Nicky's going, not to burn too many matches, especially with chasing those small little bumps.
Sort of the game plan was to try and find those bumps.
We got into a nice rhythm on the water, and I could try and predict where Nicky was going and how hard he was going to have a second gear, because I've noticed Nicky always does that. You think he's going 100% and he's got another gear.
Every now and then you kind of tack across and then you try and almost go with the swell. And if you time that right again, you can do a lot of damage, because you can, if you get a little bit more of a boost than everyone around you, just to catch back up to you, they have to like put in a quite an effort. So as you get closer in, then you can start to pick up the swell again. And basically, I was looking for the right time to time that where you get the swell and you get the boost past the other pulling. So at that stage, Hank and Josh were pulling, and they were pulling hard.
I said to Josh, like the day before, I said, you know, if it comes down to an end sprint, we're going to have to like have the pull with like a K to go and then see what happens.
Got about 3 Ks to go, probably less, 2 Ks to go, and you're looking at the top three crews. It's been incredible racing. McGregor and Finn, Burkett, Nick Naughton, and the Mocker brothers, Jasper and Darwin. So they've just been doing interval after interval, and they've all got back together after really, really, really having a great race. Around the island, a lot of tactics, put the paddles down. Now everyone's taking their turn, working really hard, and we enter the home straight, 2 Ks to go, maybe.
With about 2 Ks to go, you know, you're kind of thinking, gee, you know, this could be anyone's race. Like, we're still in it.
Tested two or three times, and then found kind of when I wanted to go, when the swell jacked up a little bit, and then kind of just gave it horns and really hoped that we had it in the bag. The bunches, the two boats split up, and, you know, then to get back onto the other person's wave, you're probably going to lose out. At that point, you've now decided that it's like flat out to the end.
Nick and Andy just put down the hammer and they really put in a big strong finish, and we just couldn't match their pace. So
but ultimately it was the best choice for us. I think we got that little bit ahead, managed to get another little boost, and then just really tried to hold on to that.
There we go, guys. Last couple of 100 meters, they got the finish line in sight. They can see the cars.
So we saw that, and then just hold it through to the end. Just, there's a sort of somewhere between this like real happiness and joy, but also this relief. And I think together you're like, oh. A lot of the race is a struggle. It's not like you're going, like, you know, every now and then you may be recovering on the way, but a lot of the race you're really giving it.
Having three boats coming to the end here all together, you know that with 2Ks to go, you could be third, you could be first. You don't know how it's going to play out until the end. I mean, none of the guys have really showed their hand right until the end.
You know, you can't really describe it, I think, until you've come across that line, especially in such a field. It's just like, whew.
I think if you are a paddler, if you're a surf ski paddler, in fact, if you're a paddler anywhere in the world, this is a race you want to come and do. Number one, Cape Town is one of the most beautiful cities in the world. Come and enjoy it. Paddling on Robben Island, I think anyone in the world has heard about Robben Island.
Yeah, so I mean, today is a special day, being Freedom Day, 27th of April. And for those that haven't figured it out, the long course is 27 kilometers as well. So 27 April, 27 kilometers. And I think for those that went around today, it must be spectacular.
Be able to do something on Freedom Day, Freedom Paddle, and have so many people connect with the beauty of our city, the beauty of the ocean, and also the history of what it is, of where this country has come from, was quite special. And we're just really glad that we're able to put that on and have so many people have so much fun. It's been really an awesome experience.
Yeah, so I did the short course today with my daughter. It's her first paddle. Absolutely awesome conditions out there. It was hard paddling with a bit of a weight in the back of the boat. I'm used to sitting in the back with my doubles partner powering us on. We had some dolphins out there on the way back, which sort of added to the excitement. I had a lot of fun. I saw the winners come in. I mean, the three boats sprinting right to the end, sort of giving it their all. Phenomenal stuff to see.
Well, all good things must come to an end, and what a good thing this year's event was. A record turnout with over 370 paddlers of all kinds coming together on this Freedom Day, celebrating South Africa, celebrating paddling, and more importantly, celebrating life. So, looking at the results, Nicky Notton leads his partner Andy Burkett over the line for their first Freedom Paddle title, and with it, they claim the national S2 title with a brutal display of strength. McGregor and Fenn settle for second, but not after trying plenty of times to break up the field from the front, and they almost got it right. With the evergreen David Mocha and his younger brother Jasper wrapping up the places on the podium, edging out Kenny Rice and Uli Hart into fourth. So looking back at the women's results so close, Pippa McGregor and Bridget Hartley were champions by the narrowest of margins over Kira Bester and Jade Wilson, Christy McKenzie and Jordy Peake completing the podium for the women. A perfect day out on the water saw new national S2 champions, but the real champions here today, of course, the human spirit, freedom, and everything that it represents. We'll be back next year as this event continues to grow, and it will be as exciting as organizers add new layers to the Prescient Freedom Paddle. Thanks for watching. We'll see you back next year. The 2022 Prescient Freedom Paddle was proudly brought to you by Prescient.